Good morning. It's Thursday, January 31st, 2013. We're coming up to 9 a.m. on the East Coast, and my name's Stephen Whiteside. I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are flat, so we are looking for a quiet open Thursday morning at 9:30. Well, we saw a little selling on Wednesday, not enough to set off any alarm bells. It's the last day of the month, so today and tomorrow we've got that end-of-month bias, which is a bullish cushion under the market as we see automatic money enter the market, and that usually alleviates any major downward pressure. We saw a little selling in Hong Kong overnight, a little buying in Shanghai, a little buying in Tokyo. One of the major news stories over the past few weeks has been the downward pressure on the Japanese yen as the Japanese government is trying to spur exports by devaluing their currency. And so that's what that looks like. And it's been going on for quite a while. Looking at the U.S. market, we're waiting for these to contract at some point, the S&P to come down, the VIX to come up. The VIX has moved up over the last couple of days, but we're not seeing a lot of downward pressure up there in the S&P 500. A similar situation for the NASDAQ. We've seen weakness in the index price, but no major movement in the VIX. And so a lot of the downward pressure on the NASDAQ, of course, has been Apple Computer, which is still not going anywhere. So bonds continue to move lower on Thursday, and I watched a presentation last night talking about how bonds are going to collapse, and that might be true. The last sell signal that we got was up here, and we've been short all the way down. A little bit of upward pressure here did not close above the upper channel line. Little upward pressure here did not close above the upper channel line. So technically, we are still short this market with just a partial position. Now, I look at this market. I listen to the presentation. It sounded great, and I maybe bond prices are going to continue to go lower. But right now, I'm at the bottom of the panic zones. I've got a pressure zone forming. I've got the pros who are not that far away. They are not running away from this market at this time. And so it looks like the pros could come back and take control at some point in the not so distant future. And so just an oversold bounce, maybe that's all we'll get. Maybe back up to resistance here, who knows. But I think that an upward bounce in bonds would be a catalyst for downward pressure on the stock market. We're certainly not seeing that on Thursday morning, so nothing to be concerned about. Looking at a weekly chart of bonds, here's where we are at the 143.75 level. If you look back here, there's an enormous amount of what was resistance on the way up is now going to be support on the way down. So while they're talking about a major decline in the bond market, I'm talking about a major band of support here. And I really don't expect to see bonds to be able to break through this support unless something major happens that we don't know about. But so far, the downward pressure on bonds has been calm, cool, and collected. It just moved from one line to the next line. And to me, that is just a normal market move and not a market collapse. Looking at the U.S. dollar, continued lower on Wednesday. That's supportive for higher stock prices. The euro moving higher, that's supportive for higher stock prices. So the S&P 500 still holding its gains here. A little bit of upward pressure from options traders ahead of the stock market moving lower. So, you know, this is the time and place if you want to go long volatility, but we do not have to be short the stock market yet. The NASDAQ 100 continuing to trade on a sell signal here, traded above the upper channel line yesterday, but closed lower on the day. The VIX for the NASDAQ, even with Apple Computer, options traders are not that negative on the market so far. We had a bearish reversal day for energy stocks, so yesterday might have been the high for that sector. We'll just have to wait and see. A reversal for gold stocks. They got up towards the lower channel line yesterday and reversed, as did the price of gold and silver going into the end of the day. A big down day yesterday for the transport, still on a buy signal here, of course, had a lot to do with a weakness in railroads, and that drove right down into the channel, so we'll have to keep an eye on that sector next week. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices. No changes in the energy sector on Wednesday. Crude oil continued to move higher. Gasoline continued to move higher. And great if you're trading this ETF. Of course, not great for the rest of us who have to buy gas. Natural gas was up yesterday. There's an open gap there that natural gas has to deal with. And so it's going to be very hard to get up and over that. Taking a look at copper, back up at the December highs, big up day for copper. Gold moved up, traded through the upper channel line, but did not close there. Now, the futures contract did, and futures closed before the ETF did, and so the ETF came back into the channel. A close above 162.41 would give us a buy signal on Thursday. Still having trouble getting through the moving average convergence there, and we have a nice triangle forming, so a breakout of that triangle would be bullish. Looking at silver, similar situation. It is back on a buy signal, though. It did close above the upper channel line, but lost much of his enthusiasm going into the close. Still having trouble getting above 31.25, and we have a new triangle there, and still trying to get out above the previous high from last week. Okay, take a look at my five stocks. Apple Computer, no change. We've got a big open gap there to deal with, and so far we haven't really tested the bottom of that open gap. And so that would be a significant test. If they can start moving into that open gap, then we could look at the top of the open gap as a potential target. But so far, we just have to deal with the bottom of the open gap. And of course, nothing happened on Wednesday as we closed lower on the day. We moved up yesterday for the CME Group. We moved up yesterday for Google. We moved up yesterday slightly for Goldman Sachs, still trying to hit 150 there. Visa continued to move lower, so we're short Visa right now, hoping it continues to move lower. There's a nice open gap here that could potentially be a target for Visa. Research in Motion. Yesterday morning, we looked at that open gap as being a target, and we traded right into it. So I'm looking at $11 as our next target to the downside. If Research in Motion, which will be called BlackBerry, we'll be looking at that as the next target to the downside if it continues to move lower. Taking a look at Facebook in the pre-market this morning, down $1.95 last time I checked. That would generate a sell signal if Facebook closed there at the end of the day. And Amazon down 176 in the pre-market this morning, not enough to generate a sell signal if it closed there at the end of the day. Last up this morning, quick look at some 60-minute charts. The VIX for the S&P 500 is edging up above the flypaper channel. Still hasn't broken out above the 200-hour moving average. So a little disconnect here between the VIX and the market itself. We've looked at the S&P 500, and as I mentioned many times, as long as we don't break through the flypaper channel, any pullback here would be normal. The NASDAQ 100 does not look as strong as the S&P 500. It's been trading sideways for quite a while now, and so we're looking for a breakout of that band. That would certainly tell us which way the market's going next. Nice big open gap there to fill. And so we'll be interested to see if we can take out last week's lows in the NASDAQ 100. Now, on Thursday, what we're looking for is for the market to turn around and move higher. We're looking for the VIX to get back down below 1364. The S&P 500, we're looking for it to move up above 1506.91. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for it to get up over 2749.08. And for the XAU, for gold and silver stocks, we need an hourly close above 152.69. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning. Looking for a quiet open, not looking for a lot to happen on Thursday or Friday, as it is the end of the month and the start of the next month. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.